Why do the knowledge judgments of divine great men or eminent scientists differ from those of ordinary people? Why does the way of thinking or the think style of divine or holy or great person, different from common people? Yogi Rupnathji said, "Look. Whatever I say now, remember that again and again. The ignorant person who observes this mortal body for himself, understands it to be the essence of truth, is overwhelmed by his senses or body wind like a mighty enemy, that is, he destroys all of his influence being as subjugates body. Just as the same entity of the water and wave, similarly the entity of this nasal air or artificial body in the entity of the unique soul. Just as the strong current of water being unconscious shows wanders in various ways, comes back, goes away, so also the ignorant people engage in various activities, traveling, views on in various forms. Unique absolute soul recognition is am self-perceived in the form of self-sacrifice. If I am a separate inanimate reflection from the inanimate body, then what is me entity? As for contemplation, there is no origin of new alternative objects. Impermanently restless forms, unable to establish omnipresence everywhere. Since one substance is action or effort, the other substance is knowledge or meaning, they cannot both know or hear or see each other. The unique absolute soul is eternal, so am not subject to any one or particular form. Just as the illuminating lamp has no action other than revealing the object, similarly the unique consciousness has no action other than total manifestation. Just as a strong psycho wind speed drives a rock, so does a psychoanalytic organism manage all these bodily organs with mental power. As sun does reveal the cloud, covered self. The absolute soul of unique consciousness, which falls into the state of the object, takes the form of that object, that is, the mind of that object, and assumes the form of the witness vision itself. The self-consciousness of this body as a witness am self is the most sacred, should accept that am body by carefully purification. Desire originates collectively in the animal world, desire, or alternatation or delusion is the cause of all sorrow. The omnipresent proof or atomic nature of the unique absolute supremacy is revealed by the division of directions, place, time, etc. The pronunciation of the word God indicating in duality as speaker and speech, does not exist in absolute consciousness. This world is being seen where it does not exist. These are the inanimate conditions those have seen, their long dormancy or state of unconsciousness. Just as the entity of an object is seen, similarly its destruction is perceived. Both living beings and the annihilation of human beings are imaginary in the obsession of inanimate desire, not created by any particular substance. The definition or determination of differentiating intelligence is a sign of inanimate nature or breath or falsehood. It is dissolved in the intellect by the practice of samadhi. The banyan tree, for example, grows once in many places, but not again in the place where the tree is cut down, so is the system of creation of this world. Ignorance has no substance, so materialistic characteristics or energy varies on country and time. The desires are the essence of inanimate or unconscious or ignorant people, so they gotten by dead action fruit. Who is ready to carry that which is incompetent or indirect? All the creatures in the universe are transient like cloud electricity. When there is no other different self-independent or individual substance in the name of action, then it is impossible to have any indirect knowledge of that. All feelings of happiness and sorrow are introduced or vibrating as inertially inanimate dualistic non-existing elusive lie bodies, not as unique absolute direct soul or spirit. The shadow of the fire falling on the water is not different from the water, so this visible universe is nothing but consciousness. Lie ego, the birthplace for second heaven, governing being this inanimate universe. The object from which the illusion of origin is originates in another object, is used being as its cause factor. All visual or ego-minded objects are repeatedly destroyable, so they are elusive lie. The object that acquires intellect is its own intellect features. When objects or bodies are unearthly or non-material like a false dreamer, then who will be appear in subject to whom as for what? There is no other scope except unique wideness. This elusive universe is not an external earthly object, the liar mindness thinks of himself as an indirect external object. The person who does not try to alleviate the disease of desire, called devil. If no external object can be seen with the eyes closed, then where is its truth? The false seen thinks of its own visibility. The unique absolute consciousness is not a matter of being known in that way. The universe is not a form of unique consciousness. The universe is not a form of unique consciousness, so it is certainly not the same for everyone. Do trees or stones ever appear from the sky? In a dreamy city, one thing becomes millions of things, there can be millions of years of knowledge in a moment. Where there is a feeling of unprecedentedness, there is a wonderful conviction, and where the former is felt, there is no longer felt as wonderful, the inanimate universe begins to appear in the form accustomed to feeling. By the thought vision as for fore and aft, the knowledge clodification about the tradition of inanimate material become ceases. Those who discriminate between country, time, action, product, etc. The universe entity appears in the ignorance of such ignorant people. The determination of dreams in future events, that is the combined ego in smell, feels this whole living universe. The fact that this whole world is calm, this can be understood by their mutual equality, truthfulness, essence, unity, indifference, inherence, inherency, co-relationship in between both of the universe and universal consciousness. What is known by the eyes, ears, etc. is in the unknown subject or substance, and in what is already known, memory reform is equal to it. So before knowing or understanding, the presence prestige of the unknown is in being proven. Lack of lack, his feeling, lack of it too, everything is zero. The eyeball or cornea of the eye stays or remains the same even in the eyelid or awake or shut down of an eye. In the same way, when this blinking moment is lost, the unique absolute consciousness remains. A person who has been able to accumulate peace and contentment by avoiding the will of the anti-scrupulous body, in this world that person is an ascetic. The phenomenon of materialism is nowhere outside or inside. If there is no reason for the aggregation of constituents, then how does the origin of matter is possible? When there is fear, etc. The resentment that arises in the heart, these are by the result of those collectively inertial inanimate vibration. There is nothing material about the flow of feelings and dreams. The absolute unique soul consciousness is the calm, imperceptible or clandestine or unvoiced and other. In this bodily universe, animals constantly hear the sound of the unwounded omniscient noises. This uninvited sound is similar to the wordless nature of the entity loyal to the whole universal body of matter. In the case of repeatable dream transfusions, the inanimate lie spectator is used as the living and dead by the abandonment and acceptance of those ego bodies. No front view or perceptiveness is real. Egoism, desire, duality, and realistic thoughts ideas which exists in visual or perceptive matter, that inanimate spiritless person is capable of accomplishing the process of levitating in sky, etc. What is am direct self spirit, if am is be knowing indirectly, is called a lie or illusion. Just as no one is inclined to taste his own flesh, so the unique conscious soul is not inclined to desire anything. Inertia or establishlessness or dreams or resolutions or breathing or false means attitudes or moods, so that should be abandoned. Does the wind ever leave the sky, exploring worldly happiness? Those who are false accumulation of inanimate intellects or unconsciousness, does not have their contemplation with the unique conscious soul, leads to very sad helpless condition. The body and the mind are opposite to each other, where they have proper intercourse, the one who expresses affection with similar happiness is called demon. Don't be trapped inside the body lotus like a bee in the greed of false sense of vain smell. What is the relation or form with the illusory? Seen or visual object. In this world only the formless mind or ego is born, and the mind is enlarged. There is no manifestation of determination in this universe, like in cloud electricity, but it is glowing, fleeting, inanimate, confusing. Whoever has his own form, how can he have his absence in it? I am or happen to be man or woman or object, such a sentence is crazy or ignorant or inanimate delirium. Just as there is no productivity or destruction in the sky of the bowl, so there is no connection of the unique absolute soul with the body. Everyone is contradictory because of reflection or revelation or alterations, where the moment is become eternal time and eternal time could be moment. All the thoughts or feeling or lack are nothing but alternatives or reflections of the unique soul itself. The smell of flowers is in the shelter of the sky, even if the flower is spoiled, the smell is not spoiled. The tree exists in the seed without sacrificing its own leaves, flower, etc. In the same way, this universe is in the womb of consciousness, without giving up its duality. Why do people just try to be happy? But why the happiness of those who try never lasts? How can people get eternal happiness? Yogi Rupnathji said, while answering all these burning questions. Look. Foolish ordinary people think that dreams can work on their own. Ordinary common people are not only fools, but also false temptation, false persuader, having dream, those are getting family with her. In this way they get the only uncertain lie. Look. When a problem like a lotus suddenly appears in the sky, that desire or problem was not there before because he am was drowning in happiness, now he am just has to suffer always in the desire to get rid of the problem. If I do not have these happiness or sorrow desires or problems or body, mind, intellect, thought objects, then what do I gain or harm by thinking of the joys and sorrows of those who try? Only human beings can uniquely realize the absolute soul as a unique absolute pleasure, so it is inappropriate to waste it. Is it because of innate instinct that people are constantly rushing towards one scene or demand after another? Are they independent or dependent on it? Yogi Rupnathji said in response to such serious questions, see. Stupid ordinary or common people are just like monkeys. They do not know how to adopt the nature of the swan in a unique way. As monkeys, they are addicted to body or son or wife or relatives or friends, etc. So for them they are constantly jumping on the trees, in this way they are getting to know themselves like the fruit of a tree in those trees like a universe. So thus they got the schedule of their death so as to forget the eternal longevity of their eternal joy. Are not they or arrogant people responsible for the unfortunate fate of that ignorant common man in the form of their own will? Thought itself is a lifeless thinker, it is a dream-like false substance with no direct evidence of its existence. So there is no duality of thought, dreams that lie nothing is found directly in him. The universe has so much surplus energy that no one needs to think for themselves. While Yogi Rupnathji was discussing the unraveling of the top mysteries of life in the universe, one of the listeners asked him a question, what is the cause of the infinite potential of the universe? Then one of the students asked Yogi Rupnathji another question, why are things not visible and invisible at the same time? Everyone looked at the boy in surprise. Yogi Rupnathji then calmed them down by pointing at them and began to speak, then he said. He who am is the unique absolute consciousness, the absolute blissful absolute happy soul, is not an object or subject, so no laziness, fatigue, grief, these material things are not acceptable to him, that is why he is the abode of this eternal endless creation. This is the answer to your first question. Now he looked at the student and said with a smile, how can the existence of a thing that does not exist as its own perception or realization be proved to be true if it wants to disappear indirectly? The action that is as uncertain as thought, the result of which, as a result, is another uncertain thing. The essence of all of us is the omnipresent unique perfect absolute happiness, the manifestation of the Supreme Spirit. Why is it so difficult for ordinary people to know and understand or grasp the subject of Divino Logi? Why can't common person embrace unrivaled absolute self-science? In answering these eternal questions, Yogi Rupnathji said, look. Inanimate quality can accept one's own quality as inanimate quality, not the absolute soul. The substance that is generated or evolutionary or escapable or concealing in nature, has no idea or sense of certainty. The human body is impermanent, many, or eternal, inanimate, mutable. The different names for the limbs of a tree are gifted by another person. An inanimate object sees its own form. The human body is inanimate or unconscious, whereas absolute science is being consciousness, so it is difficult for the inanimate animal body to comprehend or realizing absolute divino logi. All people are instinctively addicted to psychosomatic sensations or to animals or relatives, which hinder self-improvement, causing harm. They are completely self-deprived. The meaningless lies or erroneous being cannot understand the immutability of absolute soul. Whoever has form, has birth, or destruction, thought or desire is his own matter. Therefore, it is obligatory to apply silence to the words, to the state of inactivity towards the body, pranayama against to the mind. There is no oil without an establishment, just like oil lamp has no ability be ignite except about the fire, fire is always inseparate from the production or destruction of the lamp. Lamp, eyes, visibility, these three are no different from radiance. Can the one who has taken refuge in the fire god have the fear, winter, or the sorrow of darkness? The one who am dream, slept in, awake to, the Supreme Spirit proves self. There is no existence of a name morphological the present nominal characters or body or bodies etc. other than Supreme Soul. Thoughts of the mind, utterances of words, visions with the eyes, hearing with the ears, perceptions with the mind, everything is fleeting, false, perishable. God consciousness is not the perception of ones, he is not the subject of perception, he am himself is knowledge realization. What is the realization of the self-expression in the non-existence of the self-object, that is, the object that can be obtained by thought action? The arrogant creatures of the body are unconscious. All sorts of objects are distinguished by time and place, they could be separators of other differentiator objects also. The ability to generate energy in action is derived from absolute direct. Scenario meaning is subject to direct or absolute action, not to be the indirect will of the human body. There is no need of intellect or physical senses to express the absolute unimaginable. Explaining in detail how human beings turn into ordinary abominable creatures. Yogi Rupnathji said, "You must be listen attentively to what I am saying, otherwise you will not be able to escape from this eternal mazeable, miserable, eternal world. Look. Respiratory visibility is the distance between a large number of inanimate objects, that is, not the direct absolute soul, or the eternal or continuous or true object. When there is fear, etc. The resentment that arises in the heart these are by the result of those collectively inertial inanimate vibration. If there is no reason for the aggregation of constituents, then how does the origin of matter is possible? No object changes its original form or disposition. As a thing acceptance is not abandonment, but the person is not being twice. There is no other separate sky in the case of pots. What is known by the eyes, ears etc. is in the unknown subject or substance, and in what is already known, memory reform is equal to it. So before knowing or understanding, the presence prestige of the unknown is in being proven. What is am direct self spirit, if am is benowning indirectly, is called a lie or illusion. In speaking and expressing about the subject of the whole universal creation, Yogi Rupnathji said, "Look. The number of infinite forms of my body is incalculable. In the midst of these countless forms, it is me and it is not me, how can detect ourselves? In this way can we does know ourselves? Any two objects, that is, the inanimate state alone, does can be infinite. Is an inanimate state ever eternal? Whether an inanimate form is ever eternal? The combination of legs, knees, waist, abdomen, arms, neck and head etc. If this body is me, then what, I am my arms. Or legs. Abdomen. Or head. Etc. Or the whole body is me. Numbers is not in Advaita Adisthana. Self-perfected true matter is authority, and action is untrue imperfect matter. Apart from Ajapagayatri Brahma, there is a perpetual absence of dual separating action. Visual, inanimate, unstable, non-existent, unsuitable, all visual knowledge is indirect." Then Yogi Rupnathji said in short that, "Look. Without knowing it directly, no word or meaning or knowledge is expressed as mind. That right to the word form, omnipotent in itself. By indirect form words, non-existent impossible matter, knowledge grows. There is no direct religiosity, lack of objects. Lack of yogurt in milk, in the form of milk itself. All other types of knowledge except memory are self-evident. The basis of religion is the transcendental gospel or self-actualization, is never feel or knowledge or cause for his own religion. Or self-actualization. It is only our means of obtaining the substances of our time. In the context of discussing the mysteries of creation, Yogi Rupnathji said that, the literal meaning of the letter is subject to action. Not subject to human will. The ability to generate energy in action is derived from direct evidence. Called theory of self-expression, the ability to generate energy in action is derived from direct evidence. Called theory of self-expression. Why do the knowledge judgments of divine great men or eminent scientists differ from those of ordinary people? Why does the way of thinking or the think style of divine or holy or great person, different from common people? Yogi Rupnathji said, look. Whatever I say now, remember that again and again. The ignorant person who observes this mortal body for himself, understands it to be the essence of truth, is overwhelmed by his senses or body wind like a mighty enemy, that is, he destroys all of his influence being as subjugates body. Just as the same entity of the water and wave, similarly the entity of this nasal air or artificial body in the entity of the unique soul. Just as the strong current of water being unconscious shows wanders in various ways, comes back, goes away, so also the ignorant people engage in various activities, traveling, views on in various forms. Unique absolute soul recognition is am self-perceived in the form of self-sacrifice. If I am a separate inanimate reflection from the inanimate body, then what is me entity? As for contemplation, there is no origin of new alternative objects. Impermanently restless forms, unable to establish omnipresence everywhere. Since one substance is action or effort, the other substance is knowledge or meaning, they cannot both know or hear or see each other. The unique absolute soul is eternal, so am not subject to any one or particular form. Just as the illuminating lamp has no action other than revealing the object, similarly the unique consciousness has no action other than total manifestation. Just as a strong psycho wind speed drives a rock, so does a psychoanalytic organism manage all these bodily organs with mental power. As sun does reveal the cloud, covered self. The absolute soul of unique consciousness, which falls into the state of the object, takes the form of that object, that is, the mind of that object, and assumes the form of the witness vision itself. The self-consciousness of this body as a witness am self is the most sacred, should accept that am body by carefully purification. Desire originates collectively in the animal world, desire, or alternatation or delusion is the cause of all sorrow. The omnipresent proof or atomic nature of the unique absolute supremacy is revealed by the division of directions, place, time, etc. The pronunciation of the word God indicating in duality as speaker and speech, does not exist in absolute consciousness. This world is being seen where it does not exist. These are the inanimate conditions those have seen, their long dormancy or state of unconsciousness. Just as the entity of an object is seen, similarly its destruction is perceived. Both living beings and the annihilation of human beings are imaginary in the obsession of inanimate desire, not created by any particular substance. The definition or determination of differentiating intelligence is a sign of inanimate nature or breath or falsehood, it is dissolved in the intellect by the practice of samadhi. The banyan tree, for example, grows once in many places, but not again in the place where the tree is cut down, so is the system of creation of this world. Ignorance has no substance, so materialistic characteristics or energy varies on country and time. The desires are the essence of inanimate or unconscious or ignorant people, so they gotten by dead action fruit. Who is ready to carry that which is incompetent or indirect? All the creatures in the universe are transient like cloud electricity. When there is no other different self-independent or individual substance in the name of action, then it is impossible to have any indirect knowledge of that. All feelings of happiness and sorrow are introduced or vibrating as inertially inanimate dualistic non-existing elusive lie bodies, not as unique absolute direct soul or spirit. The shadow of the fire falling on the water is not different from the water, so this visible universe is nothing but consciousness. Lie ego, the birthplace for second heaven, governing being this inanimate universe. The object from which the illusion of origin is originates in another object, is used being as its cause factor. All visual or ego-minded objects are repeatedly destroyable, so they are elusive lie. The object that acquires intellect is its own intellect features. When objects or bodies are unearthly or non-material like a false dreamer, then who will be appear in subject to whom as for what? There is no other scope except unique wideness. This elusive universe is not an external earthly object, the liar mindness thinks of himself as an indirect external object. The person who does not try to alleviate the disease of desire, called devil. If no external object can be seen with the eyes closed, then where is its truth? The false seen thinks of its own visibility. The unique absolute consciousness is not a matter of being known in that way. The universe is not a form of unique consciousness. The universe is not a form of unique consciousness, so it is certainly not the same for everyone. Do trees or stones ever appear from the sky? In a dreamy city, one thing becomes millions of things, there can be millions of years of knowledge in a moment. Where there is a feeling of unprecedentedness, there is a wonderful conviction, and where the former is felt, there is no longer felt as wonderful, the inanimate universe begins to appear in the form accustomed to feeling. By the thought vision as for fore and aft, the knowledge clodification about the tradition of inanimate material become ceases. Those who discriminate between country time action product etc. The universe entity appears in the ignorance of such ignorant people. The determination of dreams in future events, that is the combined ego in smell, feels this whole living universe. The fact that this whole world is calm, this can be understood by their mutual equality, truthfulness, essence, unity, indifference, inherence inherency co-relationship in between both of the universe and universal consciousness. What is known by the eyes ears etc. is in the unknown subject or substance, and in what is already known, memory reform is equal to it. So before knowing or understanding, the presence prestige of the unknown is in being proven. Lack of lack, his feeling, lack of it too, everything is zero. The eyeball or cornea of the eye stays or remains the same even in the eyelid or awake or shut down of an eye, in the same way, when this blinking moment is lost, the unique absolute consciousness remains. A person who has been able to accumulate peace and contentment by avoiding the will of the anti-scrupulous body, in this world that person is an ascetic. The phenomenon of materialism is nowhere outside or inside. If there is no reason for the aggregation of constituents, then how does the origin of matter is possible? When there is fear, etc. The resentment that arises in the heart these are by the result of those collectively inertial inanimate vibration. There is nothing material about the flow of feelings and dreams. The absolute unique soul consciousness is the calm imperceptible or clandestine or unvoiced and other. In this bodily universe, animals constantly hear the sound of the unwounded omniscient noises. This uninvited sound is similar to the wordless nature of the entity loyal to the whole universal body of matter. In the case of repeatable dream transfusions, the inanimate lie spectator is used as the living and dead by the abandonment and acceptance of those ego bodies. No front view or perceptiveness is real. Egoism, desire, duality, and realistic thoughts ideas which exists in visual or perceptive matter, that inanimate spiritless person is capable of accomplishing the process of levitating in sky etc. What is am direct self spirit, if am is be knowing indirectly, is called a lie or illusion. Just as no one is inclined to taste his own flesh, so the unique conscious soul is not inclined to desire anything. Inertia or establishlessness or dreams or resolutions or breathing or false means attitudes or moods, so that should be abandoned. Does the wind ever leave the sky, exploring worldly happiness? Those who are false accumulation of inanimate intellects or unconsciousness, does not have their contemplation with the unique conscious soul, leads to very sad helpless condition. The body and the mind are opposite to each other, where they have proper intercourse, the one who expresses affection with similar happiness is called demon. Don't be trapped inside the body lotus like a bee in the greed of false sense of vain smell. What is the relation or form with the illusory seen or visual object? In this world only the formless mind or ego is born, and the mind is enlarged. There is no manifestation of determination in this universe, like in cloud electricity, but it is glowing, fleeting, inanimate, confusing. Whoever has his own form, how can he have his absence in it? I am or happen to be man or woman or object, such a sentence is crazy or ignorant or inanimate delirium. Just as there is no productivity or destruction in the sky of the bowl, so there is no connection of the unique absolute soul with the body. Everyone is contradictory because of reflection or revelation or alterations, where the moment is become eternal time and eternal time could be moment. All the thoughts or feeling or lack are nothing but alternatives or reflections of the unique soul itself. The smell of flowers is in the shelter of the sky, even if the flower is spoiled, the smell is not spoiled. The tree exists in the seed without sacrificing its own leaves, flower, etc. In the same way, this universe is in the womb of consciousness, without giving up its duality. Why do people just try to be happy? But why the happiness of those who try never lasts? How can people get eternal happiness? Yogi Rupnathji said, while answering all these burning questions. Look. Foolish ordinary people think that dreams can work on their own. Ordinary common people are not only fools, but also false temptation, false persuader, having dream, those are getting family with her. In this way they get the only uncertain lie. Look. When a problem like a lotus suddenly appears in the sky, that desire or problem was not there before because he am was drowning in happiness, now he am just has to suffer always in the desire to get rid of the problem. If I do not have these happiness or sorrow desires or problems or body, mind, intellect, thought objects, then what do I gain or harm by thinking of the joys and sorrows of those who try? Only human beings can uniquely realize the absolute soul as a unique absolute pleasure, so it is inappropriate to waste it. Is it because of innate instinct that people are constantly rushing towards one scene or demand after another? Are they independent or dependent on it? Yogi Rupnathji said in response to such serious questions, see. Stupid ordinary or common people are just like monkeys. They do not know how to adopt the nature of the swan in a unique way. As monkeys, they are addicted to body or son or wife or relatives or friends, etc. So for them they are constantly jumping on the trees, in this way they are getting to know themselves like the fruit of a tree in those trees like a universe. So thus they got the schedule of their death so as to forget the eternal longevity of their eternal joy. Are not they or arrogant people responsible for the unfortunate fate of that ignorant common man in the form of their own will? Thought itself is a lifeless thinker, it is a dream-like false substance with no direct evidence of its existence. So there is no duality of thought, dreams that lie nothing is found directly in him. The universe has so much surplus energy that no one needs to think for themselves. While Yogi Rupnathji was discussing the unraveling of the top mysteries of life in the universe, one of the listeners asked him a question, what is the cause of the infinite potential of the universe? Then one of the students asked Yogi Rupnathji another question, why are things not visible and invisible at the same time? Everyone looked at the boy in surprise. Yogi Rupnathji then calmed them down by pointing at them and began to speak, then he said, he who am is the unique absolute consciousness, the absolute blissful absolute happy soul, is not an object or subject, so no laziness, fatigue, grief, these material things are not acceptable to him, that is why he is the abode of this eternal endless creation. This is the answer to your first question. Now he looked at the student and said with a smile, How can the existence of a thing that does not exist as its own perception or realization be proved to be true if it wants to disappear indirectly? The action that is as uncertain as thought, the result of which, as a result, is another uncertain thing. The essence of all of us is the omnipresent, unique, perfect, absolute happiness, the manifestation of the Supreme Spirit. Why is it so difficult for ordinary people to know and understand or grasp the subject of Divino Logi? Why can't common person embrace unrivaled absolute self-science? In answering these eternal questions, Yogi Rupnathji said, "Look. Inanimate quality can accept one's own quality as inanimate quality, not the absolute soul. The substance that is generated or evolutionary or escapable or concealing in nature, has no idea or sense of certainty. The human body is impermanent, many, or eternal, inanimate, mutable. The different names for the limbs of a tree are gifted by another person. An inanimate object sees its own form. The human body is inanimate or unconscious, whereas absolute science is being consciousness, so it is difficult for the inanimate animal body to comprehend or realizing absolute Divino Logi. All people are instinctively addicted to psychosomatic sensations or to animals or relatives, which hinder self-improvement, causing harm. They are completely self-deprived. The meaningless lies or erroneous being cannot understand the immutability of absolute soul. Whoever has form, has birth, or destruction, thought or desire is his own matter. Therefore, it is obligatory to apply silence to the words, to the state of inactivity towards the body, pranayama against to the mind. There is no oil without an establishment, just like oil lamp has no ability be ignite except about the fire. Fire is always inseparate from the production or destruction of the lamp. Lamp, eyes, visibility, these three are no different from radiance. Can the one who has taken refuge in the fire god have the fear, winter, or the sorrow of darkness? The one who am dream, slept in, awake to, the Supreme Spirit proves self. There is no existence of a name morphological, the present nominal characters or body or bodies etc. other than Supreme Soul. Thoughts of the mind, utterances of words, visions with the eyes, hearing with the ears, perceptions with the mind, everything is fleeting, false, perishable. God consciousness is not the perception of ones, he is not the subject of perception, he am himself is knowledge realization. What is the realization of the self-expression in the non-existence of the self-object, that is, the object that can be obtained by thought action? The arrogant creatures of the body are unconscious. All sorts of objects are distinguished by time and place, they could be separators of other differentiator objects also. The ability to generate energy in action is derived from absolute direct. Scenario meaning is subject to direct or absolute action, not to be the indirect will of the human body. There is no need of intellect or physical senses to express the absolute unimaginable. Explaining in detail how human beings turn into ordinary abominable creatures. Yogi Rupnathji said, "You must be listen attentively to what I am saying, otherwise you will not be able to escape from this eternal miserable, eternal world. Look. Respiratory visibility is the distance between a large number of inanimate objects, that is, not the direct absolute soul, or the eternal or continuous or true object. When there is fear, etc. The resentment that arises in the heart, these are by the result of those collectively inertial inanimate vibration. If there is no reason for the aggregation of constituents, then how does the origin of matter is possible? No object changes its original form or disposition. As a thing, acceptance is not abandonment, but the person is not being twice. There is no other separate sky in the case of pots. What is known by the eyes, ears, etc. is in the unknown subject or substance, and in what is already known, memory reform is equal to it. So before knowing or understanding, the presence prestige of the unknown is in being proven. What is am direct self-spirit, if am is benowning indirectly, is called a lie or illusion. In speaking and expressing about the subject of the whole universal creation, Yogi Rupnathji said, "Look. The number of infinite forms of my body is incalculable. In the midst of these countless forms, it is me and it is not me, how can detect ourselves? In this way can we does know ourselves? Any two objects, that is, the inanimate state alone, does can be infinite. Is an inanimate state ever eternal? Whether an inanimate form is ever eternal? The combination of legs, knees, waist, abdomen, arms, neck and head etc. If this body is me, then what, I am my arms. Or legs. Abdomen. Or head. Etc. Or the whole body is me. Numbers is not in Advaita Adisthana. Self-perfected true matter is authority, and action is untrue imperfect matter. Apart from Ajapa Gayatri Brahma, there is a perpetual absence of dual separating action. Visual, inanimate, unstable, non-existent, unsuitable, all visual knowledge is indirect. Then Yogi Rupnathji said in short that, look. Without knowing it directly, no word or meaning or knowledge is expressed as mind. That right to the word form, omnipotent in itself. By indirect form words, non-existent impossible matter, knowledge grows. There is no direct religiosity, lack of objects. Lack of yogurt in milk, in the form of milk itself. All other types of knowledge except memory are self-evident. The basis of religion is the transcendental gospel or self-actualization, is never feel or knowledge or cause for his own religion. Or self-actualization. It is only our means of obtaining the substances of our time. In the context of discussing the mysteries of creation, Yogi Rupnathji said that, the literal meaning of the letter is subject to action. Not subject to human will. The ability to generate energy.